What you mean? Explain what you're saying. Explain what you're saying. You're wrong.
I will, but not.
Huh?
I will, but not.
Say what you just said to me.
I will, but not.
Nah, say what you just said to me.
I will, but not.
Europe, what?
I will, but not.
Hey, look. Europe, we ran Europe, okay? During the Dark Ages. Okay? We ran Europe during the Dark Ages. You know what the word Europe means? You know what the word Europe means?
Please inform me.
Huh?
Inform me.
The word Europe go back to a Hawaiian woman, which in the Bible is a Japhetic woman, because that's their biblical nationality. The Hawaiians more than the tongue of the Indian. Okay? A Japhetic woman named Europa, which they say she has she was a princess that Zeus carried her away to the island of Crete. Okay? That's what the word Europa go back to, a Japhetic woman, which is going into pure madness. So that's where the word Europe go back to. The so-called white man, according to the Bible, he not no European. You see, the so-called white man, he ain't even white. He's red. Okay? He's different shades of red. The so-called white man, he not even Caucasian. Because Caucasian is a term that got put on by another white man named Johannes Blumenbach, okay? And the reason why they put that term on them, because they was in the Caucasus Mountains. Because we pushed them up in there because they were fucking up the economy, okay? That's why we pushed them up in there, because they steal and rob and take everything, shit that don't belong to them. So we pushed them up into the mountains, okay? And they biblical nationality are Edomites. Okay? Now, showing you those laws, according to the Bible, the Negroes that you see on this sign are the real, true biblical Hebrew Israelites. Okay? Give me Deuteronomy 28, the food on one. You know what I want, 6 days. Now really you can jump to 15 and then jump to 28, 15, then give me 47, then jump to 16.
Deuteronomy 28, 15.
Okay.
But it shall come to pass, if thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and do all his commandments and his statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So a curse, when you look it up, it means bodily harm. So the Heavenly Father is telling his people, look, which are the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, look, if you don't hearken and listen to what I'm telling you, bodily harm is coming to you, which is a curse. Okay? Go ahead. Okay.
It says, the Lord will smite thee with the botch of Egypt, and with emrods, and with the scab, and with the itch, whereof thou cannot heal.
Emrod is like hemorrhoids. So the Most High hit our people with plagues when they was on them slave ships. Okay? That's why they were dying left and right. Okay? Go ahead.
The Lord shall smite thee with madness and blindness and astonishment of the heart. And thou shalt grope at noonday as the blind gropeth in darkness.
Meaning they in other words, they so fucked up as a people. They is trying to find the truth, and they can't find it. Meaning they going into all these other philosophies. They going to all Rastafari, Moors, Egyptology, Scientology, Hinduism, pure man. They going into all that, groping through noonday, trying to find the truth. But the Most High got them blind. They mad at her because they can't find it, because this Bible been sealed and hear from them, okay? And that's why we out here on the highway and byway to teach our people who they are, okay? Read that again.
It says, and thou shalt grope at noonday as the blind grope in darkness, and thou shalt not prosper in thy ways.
Thou shalt not prosper in thy ways. That's why as a nation of people, that's why we the lowest is robbing us and taking everything that we built and claiming it for himself. And the other nations are feeding off of, us too while we're in this condition. Okay?
It says, and no man shall save thee.
And no man shall save thee, meaning redeem thee out of these conditions. Okay? Not no Martin Luther King, not no Marcus Garvey, not no Malcolm X, not no, what is it?
Jesse Jackson.
Not no Barack Obama, because he ain't our people, he's a heathen. Okay? He's a so-called Arab. He not no Arab. We are Hebrew Israelites. Okay? Go ahead.
It says, thou shalt betroth a wife, and another man shall lie with
thee. That's why you got all this adultery, man. You get an old lady, some other dude creeping into your house. While you out working, you see, you think she your old lady? She done slept with 15 niggas before you even got with her. You see? Go ahead.
Thou shalt betroth a wife, and another man shall lie with her.
Even in slavery, when the white man had us in slavery, he took the women from us and raped them. Okay? Go ahead.
Says. Thou built an house, and thou shalt not dwell in therein.
Yeah, we built up all these things, and we don't own shit. And even when you you get married to these women out here, she filed for divorce, and you done built up the house, and you ain't even in that something. But the white man favor her.
Thou shalt plant a vineyard, and shall not gather the grapes thereof.
Yeah, any substance you try to gather to make it, shit, it's over. Any land you try to plant, white man gonna take it, just like when we were sharecropping. We were doing all that, sharecropping and picking cotton, all those things that we were doing as a nation of people, and the white man benefited off of all that shit. You see that?
Verse 32, thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people. That's slavery, man. That's slavery. You got our people scattered all over the four corners of the globe. You see? That's the curses that fall upon the Negro, Latino, and Native American, which are the Israelites. Go ahead.
And thine eyes shall look and fail with the longing for them all day long.
Like you can watch the movie Roots, you can watch Mandingo, all those movies that the so-called white man put out, you can see what he was doing to our people. That's in the Holy Bible, that's in the King James Bible.
So I got a question. I reverted to
it. I can't hear you.
I reverted to it.
You reverted to Islam.
Yes.
Right. Now, do you know?
Now, my argument is that I hear you, what you're saying. You're talking against every other religion, but you say everything's in the Holy Bible. Vice versa, when I see a man that produced more Christian books than any man on the face of earth, even the Pope introduced them in his house, but he didn't talk. I'll tell you that one day he wrote a Quran. He sized the English Bible up to the Arabic Bible, and none of the world's messed up. So it's hard for me to read something that another man placed in you to believe.
Alright, give me, you know what I'm talking about. Now, I'm gonna give you the history on the Quran. Okay? I'm gonna give you the history on it. Now, during that time you had the so-called Arabs in our land during the Crusades, okay? You had Cathedral, Warwick, and Muhammad, okay? What our people did, meaning the Negroes, created that Quran and pushed it on them Arabs, used Muhammad to push it on them Arabs to control them Arabs. And what had happened was, it got so out of control to where it just took off. That's where that Quran go back to. Our people created it. That's all of that. Allah, which means power, that's a myth. You see?
Allah means power.
Power. That's what it means. That's the English term. But in the Hebrew, it means power. okay? And that's a myth, okay? Putin just said, Putin just threatened them Arabs that he was going to blow up Mecca. What they going to do then when he light up that rock? You see that? But, like I was saying, they came up with that, that Islam madness to control them Arabs, which our people did. The Negroes came up with it, okay?
Who was the man that came up with
it? It was Waka, which they was Israelites. It was Cathedral and, it was Waka and Cathedral.
I can get both.
Discovered that.